What is up, guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Xbox Live, which we're about to do right now. There's a giant green computer in the middle of the room. This machine can make a new world, or so I'm told. What could that mean? With how little I know about computers, I don't think I stand a chance. I guess I have no choice but to leave it be for now. What is that? Is that one of those smart iPhones that I've heard about? I don't know the first thing about those things. Is that it? Shuji was like, wait a minute. We need to check. Okay, let me at least cause like irreplaceable damage here. No? Nothing in this high-tech paradise of paradise, technical paradises can be. There we go. Now we're smashing particles. Am I right? Okay. Well, nothing else in here seems breakable, so let's get out of here and go to the next destination. Where the fuck am I supposed to go now? Wait, there are three rooms? There were three rooms and I didn't know! Damn it! Okay, well, like, so we saw, like, Monokid was in one of them, right? Monokuma was in another one. And Monosuke, I guess, is the other guy who died, right? Maybe he's in the third one? I still don't know if that's a glitch or something. If that's a glitch, did I just spoil myself? Is this something that's gonna happen, like, in the trials? Or rather, like in the murder of this chapter. Oh God, I hope not. But it's interesting nonetheless, I suppose. So let's see if there's anyone around we can chat to. No, it doesn't seem so. So let's just go and get some grub then. Grub a dub dub me, scrub a dub dub in the dining hall submarine. Hello, friends. Did you miss me? And my ahoge? Hello, fellow ahoge wielder. Shuichi, is it true you found another flashback light? Yeah, it's true. Wait, so Kokichi wasn't lying? I'm stunned, startled, shocked, stupefied, you might even say.
See, I told you I wasn't lying. Good thing too, because I don't want my pants on fire.
I want to start talking about what we're going to do, but Kaido isn't here yet.
Maki isn't here either.
Oh, Maki's not coming. I didn't invite her.
Huh? You did invite her?
Forget about that killer. Hey, Miu, Keyboy, did you guys see the computer room on the fourth floor?
Well, we... Okay. She's absolutely not the character that I want to find out the most about now.
Computer room, you say? Go on!
Yeah, there was this big computer on the fourth floor. Would you take a look later?
You stupid whore. I seen you do all of that crazy shit with Kibo.
You and Kibo might know something about it, right?
I'm sorry, I'm not very computer savvy. Pull the other one, mate.
Oh, is that so? That's unexpected.
I have been meaning to ask, but Kibo, what is your talent exactly?
Well, I can do all sorts of things. Oh yeah, I'm pretty good at one-man comedy shows, if I do say so myself. I've studied the fields extensively.
Kibo's existence is the only ultimate thing about him.
Other than that, he's got no talent. I just told you I'm good at one-man comedy shows.
I don't really get it, and I don't really give a shit, but we just need to check on this computer room, right? But I'm not just gonna come just for some computer. I'm gonna take more. It's gonna take way more than that.
Okay. TMI or NEI? Not enough information? I coined that, Bojangian Place 2018.
The Monicums did say it was amazing. Hey, thanks for waiting.
Ooh. Oz, yours, oh.
Okay.
This is getting interesting. I'm getting butterflies in my stomach. Kaido and... Maki! Why is Maki with you? Well, this is about that flashback line, right? So everyone should be here, yeah? But when you say everyone, do you truly need to include a professional killer? Keep your thoughts to yourself, Kyo. I'm leaving. I miss your voice, Maki! I miss your voice! Wait, hold on a sec. Kaido gripped Maki's arm before she could leave. Seriously, you should... Are you sure that's such a good idea? Keep your thoughts to yourself, Bojinjin, please.
Kaido, didn't you just say you wanted to take down her mask or whatever? Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna take down her mask as a murderer. What? No. I just can't believe a girl like her is capable of killing people in cold blood.
Is it true? Are you really the ultimate assassin, Maki? Have you killed anyone before?
Yes. Really?
Why you hide that?
Isn't it obvious? It said she could kill us all before we figured out her identity.
You're wrong. It's because I knew you guys would react this way. What?
What? Nani?
When people learn my ultimate talent, they get the same fear in their eyes that you all have now. Eventually, that fear will turn to hate. And then someone will try to kill me because they're afraid I'll kill them first.
Sorewa.
Whenever someone learns my real identity, they try and kill me. It happens every time. Always.
Always. It's demo.
You've lived a pretty sad life, Maki, if I do say so myself. Poor Maki. I feel so sorry for you. I think I'm gonna cry.
Because of everything you've been through, human life has no value to you now, is that it?
She's an assassin, not some murderous fiend. Even if she did kill someone, that doesn't mean she thinks it's okay to...
Hey, can you let go of me now? Seriously, this is your second warning. Kaido finally let go of her arm and Maki let out a sigh. I knew you wouldn't believe me. That's why I kept it a secret and tried to avoid you guys as much as I could. As someone who doesn't know how to mind his business kept dragging me to places.
Huh? You talking about me? Fucking cunt.
However, I will say this. I have no intention of killing any of you, unless one of you tries to kill me first, that is. Having said that, you probably won't believe me anyway. So you guys mind your business, I'll mind mine, and we'll all agree to avoid each other. Please just pretend I'm not even here.
Oh, Maki, you sweetheart, I want to get to know you even more now.
It started out as a threat, but the last bit seemed a little sad.
Jeez, Kaido, what are you thinking? Are you trying to turn us against each other? Fucking idiot. You're the first one to try that, am I right, guys? I think I speak for everyone when I say you're all disappointed. We're all disappointed in you, right, guys?
No, I wouldn't say that, but...
I think I'm starting to dig Ichikok a bit. Like, it's like, I think it's Stockholm Syndrome. Okay, I finally found it. Okay, how many episodes are we in now? 20-something? I've lost count. 20-odd episodes into Danganronpa V3, Bojinjin Plays, right? I finally found the two words that describe the entirety of Danganronpa as a series, as a franchise. Stockholm Syndrome. QED.
Shall we finally get started? We've all gathered here for the flashback light, yes?
Yes, so have we all decided what we're gonna do? Use it, of course! We might be able to remember something new!
Like the true purpose of the ultimate hunt.
Well, we don't know for sure if it's got anything to do with why we're trapped here.
Don't give me that wishy-washy bullshit! Of course it's got something to do with why!
Hey, instead of arguing, it'd be way faster to just use it, you know?
Yeah, I've gone to worry, but we gotta do it. Nothing but to do it, just do it! That's the Nike way, right?
But no matter what we remember, you can't think about wanting to leave this place. If you think like that, we'll just be repeating ourselves.
I know that, and we can't go around repeating ourselves. I know that, and we just can't go around repeating ourselves. Fuck! Then let's just give it a try. Shuichi, go for it. Just do it. It's the Nike way.
I'm a little nervous. I'm sort of just plain nauseous.
Nauseous. English.
Everyone turned their eyes to me and I flicked on the flashback light. And at that moment, once again, the world warped. Sorry, that probably clipped. That probably clipped the audio like crazy. My consciousness went white, and somewhere in that whiteness, a scene played. Ooh. Whoa. Was I right? I don't know if I mentioned it before, but like, I mentioned that scene with Kaede, like, and also, Ryoma and Roma, right? Did that scene play? I can't remember. I was too fucking tired at that point. It was like the end of like a fucking 4-hour trial or something. But holy shit, did we like? Are we? Oh, did we die once before? Like, what the fuck? Because that's what I'm thinking, right? That's my theory. But that's crazy. Anyway, let's keep going for now. What was that? A funeral? It was mine. It was everyone's here. Why was I at my own funeral? What? A funeral? You too, Shuichi? It would appear we all remembered the same thing.
But what the fuck does it mean?
Fucking I don't. Yeah, this is.
What the hell is going on here? What was that funeral?
But the only thing I can remember is seeing that funeral. Nothing else. Maybe we already dead?
I don't think you're I don't know, like, yeah, you're gone to, you may be onto something there.
No way. Come on, this is fucking stupid. I couldn't help but laugh. I mean, there's no way that was all in memory of our funeral.
And what was it then, Sherlock? It was probably a memory of our school festival or something.
School festival? Now he's the one who's lacking in imagination.
Yeah, for an astronaut in the luminary of stars or whatever, you are really lacking in that department, aren't you?
Yeah, it was probably a memory from a play we did for school festival or something.
I mean, isn't it obvious if you just think about it? If that funeral was real, there's no way we'd still be alive.
Yeah, Tascani.
But aren't we all from different high schools? Why would we have a school festival together?
We'll probably remember something else about that later. Anyway, there's no way that funeral was real. There's no mistaking it. And if you believe otherwise, you're a fucking dumb cunt.
You're right. If we think about it logically, that's clearly out of the question. And I really don't want to be a dumb cunt.
Oh boy, we are soiling Kibo. He used to be such a good boy. And now he's not. No, Kibo. He's like... He has boobs pressed on him daily now. Oh man, Kibo is really shaping up to be the stud of this series, like the low-key stud of Danganronpa, right? Oh boy, the badass renegade.
Okay, good. Can't you think everyone was already dead?
Stop saying stupid shit. Look at me, I'm alive, hale and hearty. And Australian, don't forget Australian. That means I'm better than all of you cunts.
Hearty? Because you get a heart on every time you see me?
Well, yeah, but that's besides the point. I mean, you got fucking large bazongas on your chest.
Oh, I heard males can tell they're healthy by how hard they get in the morning. Is that true? God, sometimes I think I have dreams about having a penis. Is that weird? Of course it's weird. Degenerate male parts on me? That's fucking... it makes me quiver. Hey, stay in your lane, bitch. I'm not good with other people's dirty jokes.
Then tell one of your own. I want to hear a dirty joke from your lips, Chimuki. Seriously.
I wanna pop that trunk open.
Oh man, what a disappointment. A disappointment. Yeah, it's true. This flashback light was a real letdown. We didn't find out anything about the ultimate hunt. Just some weird memory.
Yeah, seriously. Talk about a disappointment.
No, I'm talking about our memory dummies. I'm not talking about the memory dummies. I'm talking about you guys.
What?
Oh no, it's nothing. I'm just lying again, so don't worry about it.
I wish you wouldn't have said that anything in the first place.
Kokichi? I got my eye on you. But more importantly, the memory of the funeral we saw. It can't be a memory of a real funeral. We have to learn more about this. No matter how hard I think about it, I can't wrap my head around it. After that experience, we ate a meal in the dining hall and returned to our rooms.
Free time? Free time? Free time? Please, free time?
It has to be free time, right? Oh man, so much shit in this fucking chapter already. Like, I'm like making a mental note of like all of the shit that we're coming across. Because again, like, I'm a seasoned Danganronpa veteran, right? So like, I have to, it's my duty to keep on top of all of the proceedings so that when the trial comes, I'm like, ha, you can't beat me, game. I know what you're doing. Or then, you know, in true Danganronpa fashion, it's like, ha, you thought all of this shit was relevant, you dumb fuck. No, this is the case, you know, and that's probably what's going to happen. But like, you know, the game, again, okay, it's Stockholm Syndrome and Red Herring, like, I think would probably be like the other, Subversion, I think. Subversion would be the other one I would use for Danganronpa. Just completely like it leads you in a certain way, or it makes you think that you're clever by not following it, and then it rips you a new one, right? Anyway.
I feel like there's some kind of secret about that funeral. I can't stop thinking about it. But it's hard to deduce anything from such a short scene. I could ask Monokuma for a hint, but he's balding, and I really don't want to go near him. I don't want to catch that balding. I'm only a teenager. Imagine if I got bald by 20. I would really take a blow at my self-confidence. I shouldn't waste my time trying to solve an unsolvable problem. I still have some time left today. Maybe I'll head out, clear my head.
Free time, yay!
Okay, well, let us, have a look-see. I've been dying for more free time. Okay. Well, luckily for us so far, right, the people that have died have not been the people that we have been kind of like fraternizing with too much, right? But so who have we already been fraternizing? Kaito, Tenko, Anji, Miyu. Well, you know that Miyu is my favorite. Like, I'm just gonna be like, again, it's probably my dick talking, right? But like, Miyu's definitely my favorite. I think, like, I'm not even joking, I think she's actually my favorite. Which probably says a lot about me. You can probably read a lot into my character and my personality and just my whole background. You know, frustrated, you know, sexually frustrated guy. because of my preferences, you know, and you'd probably be right. But, yeah, like, aside from Miyu, and she's pretty interesting, I suppose. Tsumugi? Yeah, I find her interesting. Tenko's pretty interesting. Maki is we have to try Maki now. She has to be willing to talk to us now, right? Now that, like, her secret's out. Yeah, okay, so Maki's definitely someone I'm going to talk to. Himiko? Again, I feel the same way towards her as I do towards Kokichi. Right, it's like Zundere heaven, right? Because like the whole Zundere thing is like, the whole point is like, yeah, it's so frustrating that like you get Stockholm Syndrome. Like you start to be like, oh man, like I just want them to show a bit of humanity and a bit of love towards me at least once. Right, and that's how I'm feeling towards Kokichi. It's like, it's ingenious, honestly. Right, like the way that Kokichi's, I mean, it's not like, I wouldn't say it's very sophisticated, right? You know, some people might argue that the writing in this game is not really that sophisticated, right? You know, like, sorry, Kodaka-san, like, I don't know, but I, you know, honestly, like,
I don't look at the writing of this game in terms of sophistication. I look at the writing of this game in terms of effectiveness. Right, and it is way more effective than most other stuff that I've come into contact with. Like, because like Kokichi, it's just like a hit shoot, right? It's like Kokichi, very simple, you know. Like he's a fucking brat, you know, along with Himiko, right? It's like they're perfect for each other, pretty much. They're both brats, right? And it's like the whole thing of that is like you will never get them to fucking validate your existence, right? Nothing they do is ever going to make you feel good about yourself, right? And because of that, right, that's where their charm lies, as fucking fucked up as that sounds, right? You know, some people would sooner swallow a sword than to admit that, right? Not admit, but like than to kind of be like to be charmed by these characters. And like I completely understand how they feel, right? But it's just like, but past all of it, like, you eventually have to fall for them, because they're like their quote-unquote redeeming features that you will never, like, they will never stop being fucking, like, you know, unlikable brats, right? But therein lies their charm, right? So, like, from that perspective, genius characterization, in my opinion, right? And that's always a Danganronpa strength, you know, and the strength of the writing. Kodaka-san, you know, he's a genius, you know, let me just say it outright. But, so we're talking to Maki. I'm actually interested in talking to Himiko at least once, so I might actually go ahead and do that. Kokichi? I haven't talked to Kokichi yet? Seriously? I feel as though I have. Kyo is like, in this chapter, like, it feels like he's slowly kind of, you know, he's showing a bit more personality than he did in, like, the first two chapters, which was, like, pretty much none. Aside from being a weirdo, right? And having this weird feminine thing about him. Kaito, we've already talked to. Kaito's cool. But, like, I don't know if I find him as interesting as the other characters. It's like, I like Kaito, he's like a bro, like he's the biggest bro out of like everyone, right? He's just so bro-y, like he's just like so optimistic and enthusiastic. You know, that's his one character. Like, enthusiasm would be like my, well, not just enthusiasm, bro-iness, right? Bro-iness, bro-ishness is definitely like the word I would use for him. He's such a bro, you know. Gonta, I'm sure like some people like Gonta. You know, I'm sure, like, it's more of, like, a relation thing. Like, I think he's just really nice, you know, he means well. He's the most kind of, like, innocent, I would say, out of all of the characters. You know? But because of that, like, I find it hard to find him interesting. Just me, you know? I'm sure that some people really like him. Kokichi, again, yeah, we have to hang out with Kokichi. We have to hang out with Kokichi. Koro, Kyo, a bit more interesting, but I don't know. Kibo, there's this weird sexual thing going with him. Like, he's so innocent that, like, you know, Miu's all up on him, and, like, everyone messes with him. But, like, it's just, like, there's this weird charm that comes from that. Right, how would I describe it? He's like Gonta, except Gonta's, like, a big, bad... He looks like fucking, like, he could rip you apart, right? He looks like a Hercules, right? But he's like super naive and innocent on the inside. Kibo's also innocent and naive, but like he's different in that he's like a robot. So there's this thing of like, is he like, should we approach him like a like a human being, right? Even though a lot of times he does actually ironically act like a human being, right? You know, he's always like, oh, I'm trying to learn how to be human, right? But like, you know, ironically, like he actually does like, he actually does, like, give off, like, a very human kind of vibe, you know, when he talks and stuff like that. But, like, but he's a robot, and he's really naive and innocent about it. So, like, I don't know if this is, like, a girlish thing. Like, I don't know if girls would feel the same way, but, like, you almost feel like you do want to toy with him. You do want to kind of play with him, you know, in that way, because he's so innocent. I think I've heard that before, and isn't that the whole cougar mentality is, like, they just, like, they've seen it all, you know, they've played the whole, like, you know, status and money and, like, confidence, all of that stuff. and they may be married or they have been married, right? And then like they reach a point in their lives where like they feel this weird, uncanny attraction towards like these little boys, like who don't know any better, and like it's almost like this instinct to deflower them, right? I think that's probably the most accurate like kind of insight that I have into like Kibo's character. Is like he's like a cougar magnet. And not specifically cougars, but like he hits something where you're like, okay, this is this little robot guy, and he's like, he's got all these bells and whistles, but he's super innocent. And is he really a human because he's a robot, right? I feel like I want to kind of just like tinker with him, fuck with him, right? Get my juices on him, you know, that's probably like my most accurate kind of expression of how I feel towards Kibo. But like, and I'm not even a woman, right, let alone a cougar, right? So that really speaks to how good the characters are. Hiko, I'm gonna look up that score. Like, she's 12. She's literally 12, but I want to look up that score. AKA, like, you know, she's a fucking brat, and like, that's why, like, I'm like, I just want to, like, slap her. You know, I guess it's the same with Kibo. Like, it's similar in the sense, like, you know, it's like something that like you that like really gnaws on you, right? But and because of that, it makes you really kind of just want to find out what's underneath the hood, right? And that's how I find with her, and that's what I mean by I want to look up that skirt of hers. It's completely non-sexual. Maki, okay, so okay, let me stop talking. Let me kind of stop rambling and like get to talking something. Okay, so Maki, honestly, I want to go with either Kokichi. Kibo might be. I might want to go with Himiko actually, and then in the next chapter we'll do some boys. So okay, so we've decided. Oh, actually, one thing I don't have up already, right, that I need to get up, is the Danganronpa gift guide, just for safety. Danganronpa gift guide. Alrighty. Okay, where is this girly? Change tab, please. I'm guessing she'd be in her room. Yeah, she's in the courtyard, so I went to the wrong place, first of all, but... one second, let me scroll down here, quick. Maki. Okay. Alright. Cool. Yeah, my guess is she'd be in her room. So I'm gonna look there straight away. Right, okay. Maki is here. Maki, this is probably her room. I can't just ignore what she said, she sounded really upset. What? If it's alright with you, do you want to talk? You know? Converse? Communicate? Fraternize with the enemy? Didn't I tell you to stay away from me? I'm staying away from you and the others, so just pretend I'm not even here. Oh, Maki, no. No, Maki, no! No, Maki, no! Maki, no! Please! I want to just... I just want to get to know you. Oh, this game and its characters so fucking addictive. It's like, I just want to know about everyone. Okay, well, that's a no-go, I guess. Let's find someone else. Who was the other person? Himiko, right? Himiko, where are you? You're in the basement, randomly. In the library. The last place that I would expect to find you. You've got a lot of explaining to do, young missy. What are you doing with that book over there? I know you don't read. Huh? It's back to normal? Oh shit. Did I not save it? I may not have saved it, like, because I did that weird Monokuma cherub hunt thing. And I'm probably going to do another one soon, but, like, I must have not saved it. What a fail that was, right? At the end, I completely missed it. Oh, God. It was in the gym. Well, not the gym, the storehouse.
Yeah, what is it?
Yeah. Come on, girl, give me your best shot. And when you're least expecting it, I'm gonna blow that gust of wind right up your skirt. And by that I mean I'm gonna get to know you a bit better.
Everything is paid, leave me alone. I spent some time encouraging this lazy bum. Seemed lazier than usual.
Hell yeah! Luckily enough, Himiko's entry is right above Maki's. Let me have a look. She might like this, because it's cute, right? Well, this is number 13. Yeah, she likes that, but it's not her favourite. Apparently her favourites don't start until number 48. Where's number 48? I don't have number 48. Broom. She might like that. 54. Yeah, okay. We'll go with that then. I still miss the little like sound effect from like the previous Danganronpas.
Oh, this is it. The item I needed. Not bad. Please bring me more stuff to increase my magic stat.
Okay, here's a magic tab. From Chrono Trigger.
Himiko.
She looks annoyed. Her glare is telling me to go away. If you don't want to talk to me, you could have turned me down. I guess all I am to you is a walking wallet.
I'm too lazy to say no.
Okay. I never met someone so thoroughly lazy. But that is strange. Hey Himiko, why did you decide to be a magician?
I'm not a magician! I'm a magician! It's real magic, okay? You get it right.
Sure!
Then show me some real magic!
Oh god, this is gonna frustrate me the most, because I already tell her responses like,
no, it's take too much work, but I don't have any mana.
Sure!
Sure.
I feel like this conversation will go nowhere if I disagree.
Ahoja, how many times do I have to tell you, stupid?
Huh? What?
Mahoja.
Yeah, okay.
You're right. Mahoja. Yay!
She looks really happy.
Anyway, what were we talking about? Why I'm a mage?
Why are you asking me that?
Isn't
it strange that such a lazy girl would go through so much work for a magic trick? It seems like magic requires a ton of work to repair, so...
A typical amateur question. You don't need annoying preparation for magic.
Okay...
I'm talented. No relying on my talent would go against my master's teachings.
Master? You have a master, Himiko?
Yeah, did I not tell you?
This is my first time hearing it. So there are apprentice magicians?
That's right, my master fucking how many times was a maging archmage. Hey, wait, you called me a magician again. I'm a mage.
Well, boy, I had to spend some time calming Himiko down. Blah, blah, pouty.
Stop being cute. I don't like cute girls, okay? I think they're the most repulsive thing on this planet. I particularly hate it when they wear short skirts. So don't even try it.
Oh?
Really? We get one free time today?
Oh.
Whoa. Oh no. This is... I'm gonna take back what I said about the monocoms. It was really weird. The first two chapters, like, I don't know what the fuck was going on, but now that like, these three, like, are here, like, it's really coming to a head, you know? It's really interesting. Like, the whole Monodam, like, monopoly type of situation, you know? Like, low-key dictator. Oh shit, sorry, I'm reading this, let me read this.
We can sleep in triple beds. Move the top of my floor, I'd better die. I don't know if we're that close.
Okay. That was cute. In a creepy way.
But as I said before, I like creepy. It gets me all hot and bothered.
Nighttime, I have training with Kaido. Oh yeah. We haven't done it for a while because of the murder, but we're gonna do it tonight, right? In that case, I need to go to the courtyard. Okay. I could be a dickhead and leave this here, but I think I'm gonna go ahead with it. Angie Jumanji, why are you here? Having talking with your god again?
Huh, Shuichi, where are you going?
Nowhere in particular. What about you, Angie?
Angie-wa-ne, I was just talking to the others.
Talking?
Yes, talking. You do it a lot, right? Since they can't hear Atua's voice, I was explaining his wisdom to them.
Okay. So indoctrination, right?
No, you fucking non-believer. Atua was touched by everyone's feelings, so he said we must all preserve the peace here. Nyahaha, I'm so relieved. I'll work with everyone to make this academy a paradise.
She'll work with everyone? I wonder what she means by that.
Goodbye, Nara, Shuichi. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. May the holy light of Atua guide you.
I have a bad feeling about this. Himiko's magic show was Angie's idea as well, yeah. Was she planning this time? God fucking damn it, Angie. Keep your fucking superstitious bullshit to yourself. And by that I mean, teach me everything you know about it. Please, I want to learn the ways of Atua. It looks like Kaido isn't here yet. Then suddenly, I get a noogie. Aww, that would have been cool. Like, if he come up behind us and gave us a noogie. Or whatever it's called. Hey, sorry I was late. I had trouble bringing her. Oh god. Well, isn't this taking a turn for the interesting? Go on! This is awesome. We're gonna train with the assassin? That's cool. I'm in. You know, like, I was a bit doubtful. Well, I wasn't, not doubtful, but like, you know, it was like, for me, like, this game kind of took a bit to kind of get to this point, right? But I'm in now, I'm in. Maki, why is Maki here? That's what I like to know. Ask Numbnuts over there. Someone kept buzzing my intercom and God got so fed up I finally opened the door. Then this guy grabbed my arm and dragged me all the way here. You know, don't worry about the small stuff. If we're gonna train, it's more fun with three than two, right? Huh? Training, the three of us. Is that really the reason you dragged me here? This is stupid. I'm going back. Hey, you calling this stupid? Stupid? Listen up. When a hero has to fight with a big enemy, they train, then train some more. That's what this training is. It's important for a hero like me. So you guys can be like a super dog, cat, or horse by my side to help me be the hero. Of all the examples you could have picked. Did you really think that crazy explanation would convince me to stay? This is still stupid. Stupid. I'm going back. Hey, hold on a sec. When I said I was the hero, that's just from my perspective. Even super pits think of themselves as heroes. The same goes to both of you. Each of you are the heroes of your own stories. So act more like it. Fucking cunts. I don't know what you're up to, but I told you both to stay away from me. You know this will end badly if you don't, so why are you being so difficult? No. How long are you gonna run away? Eh? What? What?
What? What? What?
Kaido brought his face close to Mark. Oh god. Your mask is coming down. I could tell just by looking at you today. Yeah. Kaido, you're such a fucking stud. That's why I hate you. I'm so jealous of your studliness. So you guys mind your own business, I'll mind mine, and we'll all agree to avoid each other. Please just pretend I'm not even here. You're not the terrifying person the others think you are. You're just a coward. No. Hey, what's your enemy? Huh? My enemy? You don't need to tell me what it is, as long as you know it yourself. So how long are you going to run away from your enemy? Eh? Run away? Yeah, you've been running away. It's pretty fucking pathetic if you ask me. But if you want to stand against it, even a little, I'll train with you so you can be strong, like me. What? Whoa, okay, that's a friendly face, if I ever saw one. Maki's getting angry. Kaido is just provoking her. Is he going to be okay? He's antagonizing the ultimate assassin. So what are you going to do, Miss Little Miss Assassin? Hey, Kaido, it's okay. You don't have to. If Fine, I'll do it. Go! Kaido, you fucking stud. Huh? You'll do it! Don't get the wrong idea. He'll just bug me about it later if I refuse. Why is Kaito a stud? Because, like, it's the fucking... He just knows people, I guess. I mean, like, there's kind of an undercurrent, like... I feel the same way as, like, it's like the same with Tenko, right? This is the interesting thing. It's like the same with Tenko, except that, like, Tenko's more clumsy. And weirdly enough, like, this is weird, you know, okay, like, I'm just using the word here, right? And I know it's a very loaded word, right? And I don't mean any offense or any kind of weird comparisons by it, but, like, feminism, right? She's like, I use fembot as a joke, right, when I'm referring to her, but like, she does represent feminism in the sense, or, no, okay, I won't say that, right, this is not actually what I wanted to say, but like, she has this feminist streak in her where, like, she wants to be strong and she wants to care about others, but, and that's cool, right, but like, It's different between her and Kaito, because Kaito's like, he has that masculine core to him, and like, I know what I'm saying is a bit controversial. You know, I'm not saying here, of course, that like, women can't do the same things that men can. Of course they can, right? You know, they can do whatever they want to do. But it's just that the energy is different, right? Because Kaito, I guess, is a man, right? You know, just putting it frankly, you know, he has that masculine core, so like, Kaito also has this look into, he cares, right, in the same way that Tenko cares, you know, he also cares, right, but like, he has this masculinity about him that is like, you know, I see you, right, and I'm gonna force it out of you because it's for your own good, right? So like, you know, this one is like, you know, basically he's like a tsundere slayer, right? You know, Maki's like tsundere plus 100 or plus 1,000 plus 1,000,000, right? And he's just, okay, I'll play your game, right? Fuck you, you're a coward, and like, getting Maki to come out of his shell, so that's why he's a stud, and that's why I'm jealous of him. Anyway. Heh, so you do get it. The only way to deal with idiots like him is to give up and just keep nodding. she likes him. I'm so jealous. You don't get it at all. Whatever, you just better get ready. I won't hold back because you're a girl. Well, what are we gonna? What are we doing first? All right, first, 100 push-ups. Is it gonna give us a scene? Damn it! I was hoping for a scene. Maybe we'll still get a scene. I'm not sure. Somehow, Maki ended up joining us, and the three of us trained together. Scene? Ah, come on! Give us a proper scene. I wish I had a big bro like Kaito. I think everyone wishes they had a big bro like Kaito. Just like, he's manly, but he's also like dumb. Like, dumb in the sense like, he just wears his heart on his sleeve, you know. Oh, nice. Okay, I take it back, we got a scene. Whoa. I love how she's in a fucking Seirafuku as well. That's the best part of this. A 100, I'm done. Maki stood up and brushed the dirt from her hands, totally composed. You're done already? You're not even out of breath. I guess you've trained before, huh? Aren't you breathing a little too hard? It's not like we've really pushed ourselves. Before coming here, I did some warm-ups. I already did 500 push-ups, so... Kaido, that was the best I could come up with. Anyway, I'm done, and you can't say I didn't train with you. I'm going back to my room. Okay, we're doing training tomorrow, too. You better be there. Maki ignored Kaido and left without a word. Jeez, why she gotta be this difficult? Hey Kaido, why did you do all this? To help her? Hmm? If someone's weak, you gotta help them out. Teamwork's important for us astronauts. If someone's weak and suffering, there's no way you can just leave them. Weak and suffering? Maki? Well, in that sense, you're... No, your case is a little different. What do you mean, different? Are you insulting me? No, you fucking dumb cunt. Anyway, let's keep going. You're still in the middle of your push-ups, right? So are you. Weren't you listening? I already did 500 push-ups before I got here. Nice try, Kaito. Now pull the other one. I don't mind if it's a girl or a boy, just pull it. Kaito, oh god. Kaito ended up saying he didn't remember how many push-ups he did. We agreed to just start over, and we were exhausted by the time we reached 100. At least they did 100. 100 push-ups is not easy. I mean, it's possible, but it's not easy. So tired. When I got back to my room, I huffed out a deep sigh and fell backwards onto my bed. Kaito bringing Maki, he really is crazy. But maybe it's because he's crazy that Maki came in the first place. Kaito, you really are something else. Cool. Anyway. One sec. Who haven't I done an intro in the verse of? Did I do Gonta yet? Let's do Gonta. I don't know, did I do Gonta? I can't remember. Oh, hello, my name Gonta. I born in jungle with wolves. I like bugs more than anything in the world. And you like bugs too, right? Right? No bad person could like bugs. You my bestest friend from now on, just like everyone else who like bugs. But anyway, things are going crazy. Gonta not really understand. Gonta's brain not really good sometimes. But he try his best. Even though Japanese dub, I sound completely normal and rational. In this, they decided to make me differently abled. But that's okay. That's what makes it fun to voice me. Anyway, so yeah. Gonta really upset. You know why Gonta really upset? It's because Shuichi and Kaito having these secret nighttime training sessions and not inviting Gonta out too. Gonta really want to. You know what would be really cool? If eventually, like, Gonta start training with these two and more people start training and it become like a fucking thing that is like a bonding activity that we do to stop all of the killing. Because Gonta not like killing. Killing is really, really not good. I know things die in the bug world all time, but killing is not good by Gonta's book. People should not be killing each other. People should be hugging and kissing and playing with bugs. That is Gonta's idea of utopia. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If not, Gonta really sorry. Gonta try his best. Gonta really do. Please don't hate Gonta. But I hope you guys are enjoying this, and I will catch you in the next exciting episode of Bojinjin Plays Danganronpa V3. Gonta love you.